yourself. What's going on in your day? The sky is red, it's Mordor. Okay? It's a elf land. It's the Shire land, Gandalf land. Don't know. What do you want? What do you want to be?
Apocalypse.
You can change easily to a night scene. You can shift to a night scene like this one I set up. Here, Barry here. My font color is purple and my environment color is blue, pink. It's purple, it's violet. It's a good color combination, okay? It makes sense. Okay. We are not talking about lightning, okay? It's another subject. We are talking about the visual effects. What you see? What's your story? Well, about Lego block. Please select in the hierarchy window the object called lake block. Select and focus on it. Lake block, editor view F, lake. There is not a lake, it's only a blue box yet. Because we don't have this luxury yet, this stage of the lab design don't allow us to put a very good looking lake because it's expensive for the performance. It's good, but it's don't need it, okay, this stage. Just a blue box would be fine. We need to know that a lake and there will be a bridge, okay? There is a blue box made.
Also,
we have a big wall prototype. What is that? In the higher view. Big wall prototype. It's our level ending. The player will not be able to pass through the gates. Okay, for this workshop, we are confined to this little land, this path, so we can block out where the player starts, where the player ends. So it's a landmark, big wall, bah, big wall on the opposite side. Okay, now we have start, we have the finish, we have a pathway, we have a lake, and we will have a bridge. Okay, it's a good level design. Things are getting shape. You know what are you doing. You have no doubts. The secret for a good game design, don't have doubts. Don't have fear. You have to know what are you doing, okay? Always. This is what prototyping is for. Wash out your doubts. Prototype things.
But then it's still. You should just make a dramatic subtle hint.
Especially
Você botou os Skytech shoes no chão.
Ah, see, that's very interesting. Okay, you can link your lighting source, in this case the sun, here, the first object in the hierarchy view, sun. I rename it the light. The real name of this sun is directional light. It's the main light unit, okay? Your main source of lighting, shadow and light.
Can we have more than one light source?
Yes, I name it you want. But it costs a lot for your computer. Be careful, okay? We have a directional light linked to the sky. Oh, that's awesome. So we can rotate the light and the sun will change, like night and day cycle. Let's try it. You can load the camera to see. Yes. Okay?
The
green lens?
Yes.
It's the close of the tree. The tree. Collapse your tree. The small arrow.
If everything is the sky, is anything the sky?
Where is the floor?
The floor
in the sky.
As you can see, when you rotate your sun, the shadows obey to the night cycle, and unit tries to mess up with the color of the environment, the sky. It's not very good, but it's working. Okay?
How do you rotate the sun?
This is it. Yeah? You click on the ring, the green ring. The button, yeah? Yeah, this one. Yes. That's it, people. So, for part two, all you need to know is where the sun is, where the shadow are, what's the color of the sky, what I want to tell to my players, what I'm doing, what the story, the color, the thought, the shadow, okay? That's enough for now.
Can we make the sun move with time?
You need to code or buy expensive assets from Unity. That's a real sky, something like that. You can.
Or you can make it.
Also,
do it yourself.
The real sky from assets, you can put some real clouds moving, something. Let's load up into level 3.
A gente falou sobre sound e lighting.
So, intro part 3, what is about? What is it about? Well, we are prototyping, but we are finishing the prototype level for this small setup, okay? Now we have the archways, we have the big walls. I want it to be castle with tower. So I created with the primitive geometry. You can go in an F box on the wall, okay? Our last wall. You see, there's some kind of tower made with a sphere and some cubes and cylinders, okay? We are sculpting, low poly sculpting, prototyping what we want to be. I want to be a huge door castle. So I put a brown door, cube door. I put it a sphere tower to simulate our castle. I wanted to have two nice flags, to have nice flags and some bricks, kind of that. Also, our bridge. We need to cross the lake. So you can fox on the lake. There a bridge there, prototype bridge. Okay? Let's fly to our proper bridge. Nice. You can play your level, hit play. You can walk. And take care, you can fall from the bridge. Take a shower. For this workshop, we will not have colliders. We will not. We are not in blocking the player. Okay, don't need it. It's fine. You will not die. So we can walk freely, see our bridge, see our block tower. And what is different about the sky? Now, what do we have here?
Dark.
We have clouds. Nobody knows. I know. Yeah. Nobody see it. We have clouds now because now we have a environment textured skybox. Okay.
How did you make the water?
You have it.
In the previous, it was just blue.
It's broken.
Yeah. You could. But now it's mega broken.
Box, right?
Yeah.
You can create
a what do you mean?
He's a traitor piece of shit.
Why?
How? He's helping the power. He's
no,
an idiot. Because he's an idiot. He's being a dumbass. He's just helping them because he's a
fool.
Even ele fica 2 anos fingindo que não has a negócio, ele não consegue, ele é tão burro que ele não entende. Tipo, ah, we're getting That's my point.
Now,
that's what I'm trying to do.
We are near to finishing the level.
No,
we are not. I already talked to you some new assets. So now you can replace our blocks. We are tired of blocks. Okay? So this level is important because of two main things. The sky, it's a cloud with a textured sky. We have the shapes of the main blocks where the game is the story will go one, we have the bridge, the lake, we have the start and the finish walls. Okay, that's enough. Our game is complete. Go and put it on Steam. Let's sell the game. So let's go to the final scene. If the final, please. Hierarchy, workshop, scene. Intro final. Aha! No blocks anymore, right?
How do we...
You can hit play, it spins around. Voice is really important. It's not the assets, the cool assets we see now. It's the proportion. So, since the beginning, we are very worried about the size of the sea, right? We don't want a bridge to be a Golden Gate. It's a small bridge. We want to have a big wall at the end. Okay, it's there. Let's keep the proportion right since the beginning. Okay, prototyping. Prototype it right. Go to the finish, right, okay, clean stuff. We have now the assets really very close to the size of the blocks, the prototyping blocks, right? Yeah, prototypes for that. Don't lose your prototype. Only if your project changes completely. Okay, sometimes you need to leave it to game over. Okay, I won't work anymore on this. The shit, oh no, I'm not happy. Okay, start from zero again. Okay. In this case, you can see that a fort well set up. Well, where are the treasure chests? Well, let's have some fun, right? I will guide you, please. The treasure is high. Workshop, assets, table, here. We have the prefab folder, please, here. Prefab. Increase our thumbnail slider to see the cool things here. And we have a lot of good objects. We have barrel, crates. We have plants, trees, bush, okay, treasure. Gold bag, money bag. But that's not the only one.
There's more.
Where's the castle? Yeah. Also, you all will know that inside the prefabs folder, we have another folder called Stone Keeper. Ah, good name, right? Stone Keeper. Inside Stone Keeper folder, inside prefabs, we have a lot more objects. So you can drag and drop the objects into the scene. Let's play RPG now. You can populate your level with these blocks, ready-made blocks. You can get crazy as you want. And that's it. So far, possible. We are creating a little lab design.
Super cool, man.
You see, you can start with Unity right now and create some some fun stuff at home, okay? With just basics. You can download free assets from everywhere, from Google Warehouse, 3dfreemodels.com. You can get all cool stuff inside Unity Asset Stores, okay? You can start your game because it's free. You can create a good game. You can sell it. Why not?
If you sell your game, do you have to pay Unity?
Only if you earn more than 100,000 dollars.
Above
$3,000. $3,000? Yeah, something like that, yeah. Please check it.
Yeah, like right now it just said that.
I think Unreal might be.
But it's different
because
at first it's...
It's a lot of money, right? Yeah. Unity will not arrest you. FBI will not get your home to arrest you.
Not for that, at least.
No.
They know the other stuff you did, so...
Well, fine.
There are a lot of indie cases, success cases, using these free assets. Mm-hmm. And selling a lot of at Apple Store, Google Store, okay? People just do that, okay?
It's so beautiful.
How would we create a waterfall?
Ah, there are a lot of techniques. Waterfall, it can be particle system, okay? But you need to master particle system to look good. You can create your old school style, like flat plates, polygon planes, with animated textures, with code that offsets the texture in UV. You can also, yeah, it's good, a combination of textures, 2D texture, and a combination of shaders with animated normal mapping that disturbs the polynormal and particle wall.
Also,
it's a
sheet
of water.
Mix that.
It's a
sheet of
water. It's a sheet of water. Thanks. Okay, come on. So, I hope you like it.
Yes.
I think it is simple, it's small, but it's cool. You can do a lot of your with this base in Unity, okay? It's your imagination, it's your cultural background, it's your good.